knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
As we learned in the previous tutorial, the adaptive immune system utilizes two major types of immune cells, or lymphocytes, those being T cells and B cells. These cells can react to a tremendous variety of antigens, for which these cells possess a large variety of cell surface receptors that can recognize an unlimited number of pathogens. To be able to generate such an astounding repertoire of receptors, BCR and TCR, or B and T cell receptor genes, are created by recombining pre-existing gene segments. VDJ recombination, or recombination of variable V, diversity D, and joining J, gene segments, is an essential step in the development of the vertebrate immune system. DNA rearrangements that generate functional immunoglobulin, IG, and T-cell receptor proteins are indispensable for the development, progression, and even the survival of B and T-cell precursors. This is initiated by breakage at precisely defined locations in DNA, and the joining is completed by the common cellular repair response, related to the repair of breakage caused by factors such as ionizing radiation or other genotoxic agents. These VDJ gene fragments are typically found as multiple copies that lie transcriptionally upstream of a constant region, C. During the development of the lymphoid cells, segments of each type are joined by VDJ recombination so as to make a VJ or VDJ array that codes for a variable region exon, which becomes linked by RNA splicing to the C region. Rearrangements occur in an ordered fashion, with D to J joining preceding before a V segment is joined to the rearranged DJ segments. Immunoglobulins, or IGs, are produced by B lymphocytes and secreted into plasma. The IG molecule in monomeric form is a glycoprotein that is shaped more or less like a Y. Basic structure of the IG monomer consists of two identical halves connected by two disulfide bonds. Each half is made up of a heavy chain and a light chain. The IG heavy chains are encoded by recombined VDJ genes, while VJ rearrangements encode the immunoglobulin light chains. T-cell receptors, or TCRs, are membrane-bound heterodimeric proteins normally consisting of the highly variable alpha and beta chains. T-cells expressing these two chains are referred to as alpha-beta T-cells, though a minority of T-cells express an alternate receptor formed by variable gamma and delta chains, referred to as gamma-delta T-cells. TCR beta chains and delta chains are similarly encoded by distinct sets of V, D, and J genes, while alpha chains and gamma chains are encoded by additional sets of V and J genes. The number of possible IG or TCR molecules has been estimated to be well above 10 million. This feat is accomplished by a highly regulated and well-coordinated set of reactions that begins with cleaving DNA within specific well-conserved recombination signal sequences, RSSs, that are adjacent to each V, D, and J coding segment. RSSs consist of conserved heptamer and nonamer elements, separated by 12 or 23 nucleotides of less conserved spacer sequences, and their relative orientation determines whether the reaction proceeds by inversion or by deletion. In vivo, recombination takes place between one RSS with a 12-base pair spacer and one with a 23-base pair spacer. This is the so-called 12-23 rule. The cleavage phase begins with RAG1 and RAG2, enzymes which work as a multi-subunit complex to induce cleavage of double-stranded DNA. These enzymes bind to either a 12-RSS or 23-RSS. This complex then synapses with a partner RSS of the complementary spacer length. The RAG complex then nicks one DNA strand of each RSS and catalyzes transesterification reactions to generate hairpinned coding ends and blunt signal ends. In the joining phase, both the coding and signal ends are repaired by non-homologous end joining, or NHEJ, the main pathway for repair of DNA double-strand breaks. But here, the coding ends are often repaired imprecisely to increase diversity, as indicated by the red nucleotides in between here. While the coding ends undergo extensive processing, resulting in addition or deletion of bases to increase antigen receptor gene diversity, the RSSs at the signal ends are precisely joined in a head-to-head arrangement, generating a signal joint, or SJ. Usually, VDJ recombination deletes the DNA between the gene segments to generate an excised signal circle, or ECS, that is covalently sealed at the SJ. The ECS is lost during cell division. Unfortunately, errors can arise during this process. They can be broadly classified into joining and recognition errors that can result in generating deleterious genomic rearrangements. Mice with disruptions of either the RAG1 or RAG2 gene are completely defective in VDJ recombination and therefore possess no mature B or T cells. These mice have no other obvious defects, which implies that the RAG genes function only in the immune system. With T and B cell development better understood, let's move forward and learn about their activation next.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.